This tutorial will show how slice routing and the slice transform effect in Resolume Arena 7 give you total control over the input to screens and surfaces. I'll be demonstrating how it's done by projection mapping a wedding cake as an example, and part of the process will be creating a photo montage on the cake. I'm using two projectors to output content onto this wedding cake. If I open the advanced output, you can see that the left screen is assigned to display 2, which is my left-hand projector, and the right screen is assigned to display 3, which is my right-hand projector. The left screen contains slices corresponding to the front surfaces of the left side of the cake, and similarly for the right side. If you were using just one projector, you would have a similar setup, except that you would have one screen with all your tier slices inside. What if I want different content on each half of the cake, and I wanted to achieve this inside Resolume, rather than preparing and importing a clip that has two different animations baked in? At the moment, if I bring in another clip and trigger them both, layer 2 adds over the top of layer 1, because its blend is set to add. I need to head back into the advanced output settings. I'm going to start using the shortcut Shift Command A on a Mac to access these settings from now on. We can see why we're seeing this on the cake. It's because all our slices have their inputs set to composition, i.e. they will output whatever is going on in our composition, which at the moment is a blend of layers 1 and 2. If we set the input to layer 1, then we see just what is on layer 1. This is technically called slice routing, as in we are routing a layer into a slice. Note that you can also route groups, virtual screens, and other screens to a slice, but I won't be doing that here. If I set the input of all the slices on the left screen to layer 1, and all the inputs of the slices of the right screen to layer 2, then any clip I put on layer 1 will show on the left, and all the clips on layer 2 will show on the right. You can highlight multiple slices at once and change their inputs to speed things up. You might notice that the content on the right is looking a little dull. That's because its visibility is set to 50% by default, so don't forget to bring that up to 100%. And we can mix and match. What if I want different content on alternate surfaces? Then I would change the input accordingly. Using this method, you can pair complementary clips in the same column and trigger them by clicking the column heading. If you made 10 layers, you could even bring in 10 different clips so that each surface displays unique content. Let's do that by right-clicking on a layer heading and selecting New. We can see a new layer is created. We also saw the shortcut listed alongside, Command L, so I'm going to use that until I have 10 new layers. I'll also drag down my composition window to make a bit more space for my layers. Don't forget to change the opacity of the layers, which is 50% by default. Take them all up to 100%. I've got 10 photos that I want to put into a montage on the cake. I want to drag them into my clip slot so that they are all in the same column. I can do this quickly by dragging all the 10 photos selected together onto the column heading. If I trigger the column, I can see that things look promising, but they aren't ideal. Opening advanced output again, we can see what's happening. Each slice is only showing the small section of the photo that it covers. What we really want is for the whole photo to be inside the slice. I'll reset the inputs of all the slices back to composition. Now we see the top layer, which is obscuring everything underneath, which is fine. We're going to use the slice transform effect. It can be found in the effects browser, but it's better to access it in the slice panel. If you don't see the slice panel as one of these tabs, go to view and make sure show slices is toggled on. What we can do here is drag either individual slices or all slices belonging to a screen, onto the composition, onto layers, groups, or clips. Let's see what happens when we drag the left screen onto layer 10. Now all the slices that make up left screen are showing what is triggered on layer 10. We can also drag individual slices onto individual clips. So now you can probably see how we're going to build our photo montage by dragging slices onto each of the 10 layers. If you're not happy with the composition of the photos on the cake, you can drag the clips onto another occupied clip slot and the two will switch places. We can also have some fun with the settings of the slice transform effect when we apply it to moving content. I'll remove the slice transform from layer 1 and apply all my slices to a single clip. In the Clip Properties panel, I can see the parameters of the slice transform. There are some interesting scaling options we can play with. We can also mirror the clip horizontally and vertically. This allows us to add some variety across our slices. If you like the video content I've been using, you might want to take a look at my shop where I sell animations, loops, and templates for cake mapping. Follow the link by clicking the card. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. If this video helped you, please hit that like button. Subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out on future cake mapping and projection mapping tutorials and videos.